Hello from Seoul. Are you looking for a new way to enjoy ramen? Today, I'm gonna share 9 crazy delicious ramen recipes from super easy ramen to quite a fancy one. So please hit the like and subscribe button before we start. When you think of ramen, the first thing that comes to your mind is probably this shin-ramen. But you can try my recipes with any kinds of ramen except for seafood flavor or ramen with no soup. You don't have to buy this ramen, just use the one you have in your kitchen. I'm using this shin-ramen because it's cheaper and this is my personal favorite. The first recipe is the easiest. I think I cannot say this is a recipe because it's too simple. Many people try putting something in ramen when they get tired of eating normal ramen. So Koreans tend to put Korean traditional sauces such as Korean chili paste, samjang, or soybean paste. It may be very refreshing for you if you are tired of it. But in my experience, ketchup is the most delicious and super easy to get. You can't say you don't have this in your fridge, right?
자, 먹어라.
나 이거 처음 먹어봐. 먹으려면 머리를 묶어야지. 안 어울릴 줄 알았는데 맛있어. 딱 맛있어.
If I say the difficulty of ketchup ramen is level 1, this ramen is level 1.1. You cook ramen with water, but this time I'll put milk instead of it. You might think that guy is crazy or something. I know that's what I thought when I heard this recipe for the first time. However, this is good. Have you ever seen ramen with cheese? That's the most lovable topping for ramen for Korean people. This milk ramen will be similar to that, but it's gonna be much flavorful and tastier. It's good to boil it with milk from the start, but it's going to overflow. So I'll tell you a better way. Plus, the soup is gonna be more neat and clean. Boil ramen with water in a pot first. And when the noodles are cooked 90%, drain the water and boil it again with 350 ml of milk. I recommend you to use whole milk. If you ruin it with skim milk, I'm not responsible for that. It is good to cook with a half tablespoon of pepper flakes and chopped green onions. But they are optional, so if you don't have them, you can skip it. I think some of you are still thinking what the heck he's doing there right now, but let me show you.
Claire!
What?
Don't worry, she's not a weirdo. Now I'm gonna make ramen which is called Kujirai style ramen. The recipe is from a comic book. I don't know if it is the writer's real recipe or just fiction, but it is definitely delicious and popular among Koreans. You will be needed ramen, an egg, and a slice of cheddar cheese. Ramen really goes well with the green onion, so it is good to have this. This time, you should bring a pan instead of a pot. Pour 350 ml of water, and when the water starts boil, add ramen and flakes. You don't have to put all the powder here. I'm gonna use half of it, otherwise it's gonna be quite salty. Change the heat to medium heat and put an egg in the center. Cheese and green onions on top. Now, only you need to do is putting the lid on to cook the egg. It seems done. Let's call ramen taster.
Claire!
Deba. 뭔가 고급스러운 요리 같아.
Do you guys like tteokbokki? I also have tteokbokki recipe video, but it is quite hard to get rice cake unless you are living near Korean groceries. This recipe is perfect for the situation. It can be a good substitute. Remember my 10-minute tteokbokki recipe? I'll bring almost the same sauce. To make the sauce, 1 tablespoon of Korean chili paste, 1 tablespoon of sugar, 1/2 tablespoon of minced garlic, and 1/2 teaspoon of ramyun powder. If you put it too much, it's gonna be too salty, so it might be better to add a little bit more depending on your taste. Let's put 300 ml of water into a pot, and when it starts to boil, put noodles, some fish cakes, sliced onions, and cabbage. Lastly, the sauce. This is it. With this green onion, it looks more fancy and even tastier.
Oh, 떡볶이 냄새다. Mm. 완전 떡볶이네. 떡볶이. 진짜 이거 떡볶이 없을 때 해 먹으면 좋겠다.
This time, let's take out a wok. That's right, I'm gonna stir fry it. You can take out any vegetables from your fridge. I can see cabbage, green onion, and some onion in my fridge, so these guys will be with me today. As I always say, cooking is not difficult. If you don't have onions, but you have bean sprouts in your fridge, just use it. Or let's say you don't have green onions like me, then just skip it. It doesn't really matter. Just go to your kitchen and try it with ingredients that you have. Today, I'm gonna stir fry it with pork. Don't worry about it. I know you have bacon in your fridge, then just use it. Boil some water in another pot and add some oil and fry some green onions. Then you can feel the amazing aroma. It's like garlic oil when you make pasta, so you can put some garlic too if you want. But I didn't prepare it in advance, so I'll skip it and put some pork. After you can see it's cooked, put some onions and cabbage. Add 1 tablespoon of soy sauce, and I'm gonna put 1/2 of ramyun powder in it. You can add more depending on your taste. You don't have to follow every single step from the written recipe. If you like spicy stuff, you can add more. Or if you want it to be mild, you can put less. Make sure it's not meth. I can see noodles are ready, so let's stir fry it. It looks a little bit dry, so I'm gonna put some water in it. How does it look? It's awesome, right?
여기요.
오케이. 다섯 번째네? 나 오늘 라면으로 사육당하는 것 같아. 이야, 그만 안 돼.
If you are tired of hot spicy ramen, let's try something new. This is called soy sauce ramen, which is so simple, and I think it is good for a late night snack. You will wake up with a swollen puffy face if you have ramen at night. Don't worry about it, help yourself at night. Here's my solution. Boil noodles first. I think you only need green onions, but if you have other vegetables in your fridge, you can use them too. I have green and red peppers at the moment, so I'm gonna use them. If you have sesame seeds, that'll be great too. The most important thing in this recipe is this tsuyu sauce, which is Japanese soy sauce. If you don't have this one, you can use a mix of normal soy sauce, sugar, and some cooking wine. Rinse the noodles with cold water and add 2 tablespoons of tsuyu and 1 tablespoon of sesame oil. Put some veggies and finish it with this egg yolk. I was supposed to put some sesame seeds, but I totally forgot it. It could have way much prettier, so guys, don't forget to sprinkle it.
여기요.
오, 야 이건 라면이라기엔 너무 예쁘잖아. 너무 예쁘잖아. Oh my gosh. 아, 후보 할 필요 없지? 대박이다. 이거 라면인 것 같지 않아. 진짜 색다르다.
It's very hard to eat spicy and hot ramen in summer. If you enjoy eating ramen, sweating a lot on a very hot day, I gotta say you're Korean or you have Korean ancestors in your family. Do you guys like naengmyeon, cold noodles? If you do, you will love this upcoming recipe so much. What I'm gonna make is cold 냉라면, which means cold ramen in Korean. Let's boil noodles first with flakes. I'm not gonna put powder in it because I'm gonna rinse them with cold water anyhow. You will be needed some vegetables, but again, you can use whatever in your fridge. I'm gonna use cucumber, cabbage, green onion, and some chili pepper. Let's make broth. Pour the powder first, and 1.5 tablespoons of sugar, 1.5 tablespoons of vinegar, and same amount of soy sauce. That's it, and mix it. After that, put 200 milliliters of water and some ice cubes. If it's too salty and spicy for you, put some more ice cubes. It's gonna be milder. This boiled egg is optional, but I'll say this is the beauty of this ramen, so put some efforts into it. The prettier, the more delicious. Last touch with sesame seeds, it's done.
Look at that, isn't it so beautiful? I need this in summer for sure.
What I'm gonna make this time is the one that gives you much deeper taste, and you're not gonna feel like instant ramen at all. It is called green onion ramen. As its name, there will be lots of green onions in it. Our subscribers may get sick of it, but I have to say it again. In Korean food, especially spicy food,
more green onions, more delicious.
Prep lots of green onions. It doesn't matter how you cut it, but I'm gonna cut it like this. Again, you can use whatever in your fridge, but today I'm using pork. If you have seafood or beef, you can use them too. But I'm not saying put beef and seafood together. Choose one. Fry some sliced garlic and green onions we prepared. It can smell something special already. Add some onions and pork now. When you see they are cooked, add some ramen powder and stir fry it. Make sure not to burn. I recommend you to reduce the heat before pouring the powder. Now it's time to add water, but just 80% of water, which is 400 ml first. The reason why I'm doing this is for making the noodles are seasoned well. When the noodles are 90% done, pour the rest of the water, which is 100 ml, and boil it a little bit more. That's it. I want to look more professional, so I'm putting some sliced green onions on it. Looks more great, right? Finally, it's the last one, tomato egg ramen. If you have tried the first ketchup ramen already, you know it cannot be not delicious. The combination of ramen and tomato is beyond your expectation, but the recipe is too simple. Boil the water with half of tomato and 1/4 of sliced onion. But my tomato is so small, so I put a whole tomato. Once it starts to boil, add some powder and mash the tomatoes so that all the juice from the tomato makes the soup deeper and tastier. It's almost done. Put noodles in it. While it's boiling, let's go grab an egg. Some people prefer to make poached egg in ramen broth, but in this recipe, we need to beat an egg in another bowl. Put some green onion, and if you have Korean pepper flakes, you can add it too. But I have some spicy chili pepper, so I'm gonna put this in. Add 1 teaspoon of vinegar. We have the last step of this recipe. Add the egg we prepared. I think I don't have to explain how egg and tomato go well together, right? What is important here is don't stir it. It makes the soup not clean and neat. Finally, it's done.
오, 맛있다.
이건 국물이 맛있어.
아, 은은하니 맛있네, 토마토 향이. 라면의 냄새가 안 나, 인위적인 냄새가. 괜찮네.
Alright, I showed you 9 different ways to enjoy ramen. Claire had 9 ramens in 2 days in a row, but she enjoyed them all because each ramen is so special. No matter how delicious it looks, don't try to make them all in one day. Not even 2 days in a row like us. They were amazing, but Claire said she's not gonna eat ramen for a while. We really wanna know which ramen appeals to you the most. Alright, this is it for today, and I'll see you next time.